Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Is there a magic? No, there's no magic button. All right. Anyway, thank you. Happy Father's Day to everyone, and thank you for sharing your Father's Day with us. And also happy Juneteenth, our first official holiday of this nature in June. What we needed, another holiday, yes? So anyway, I normally will do some of this talking at the beginning of the program, but tonight was a very special night because of this concerto that I wrote for Darrell. But let me tell you just a little bit about that, because I didn't write any program notes for you. It was to celebrate his 10th anniversary as my concertmaster with the Oregon Sinfonietta. So he asked me if I would write this piece, and I'm very pleased to say that I was happy to do so, and you have heard the result tonight. So my thanks to Darrell. Thank you, Darrell. So... And my thanks to Mark Moreland, who is our local luthier, Mark Moreland Violin Shop, because the instrument that you heard tonight is an instrument that he provided for Darrell to play on that would give a little more projection for the hall, a beautiful instrument made in Poland that Mark had customized for this particular purpose for that. So we really appreciate that from Mark. And I promised someone that came tonight that I would mention their institution as well. And because Gary Gouget, if you don't know Gary Gouget, he's a wonderful winemaker that lives in Ridgefield, and he kept me through the COVID. Thank you, Gary. So, I've known Gary for a long time, and I recommend his wines highly. And if you're not necessarily a wine drinker, go for the food. He makes a very mean Reuben, and a lot of other wonderful things as well. He's just right up there in the old firehouse in Ridgefield. So, and he told me he'll be doing his Rubens actually at the July 4th event, I think, as well. Anyway, I had promised Gary I would say that. But I'd also like to thank very quickly the folks in the ACC that provide the funding for the orchestra to help make the success that we are. My special thanks to Shelley Williams, if you saw her out front. She is our program coordinator. And yes, please give her a hand. My thanks, too, to my colleagues for their support. Dr. Doug Harris is here. Jake, are you here tonight? I can't tell. Maybe not. Dr. Jacob Funk has the best name in music I know. And he is our choral director. And so I thank them for their support. Do I have any, I should ask this embarrassing question. Are any of my administrators here? Miles Jackson, are you here? I'm not sure if Miles is here. Miles was retiring this year. I was hoping he might make it to this final concert for us. But he's been a very, very strong supporter as well. So let me think, have I covered everything and talked too long? Yes, let's do, but let me tell you just a quick bit about Shostakovich. Because this is a marvelous little symphony from 1945. If you think about 1945, it was not a very happy time in the Soviet Union. Stalin was the dictator in charge, and the World War II was just ending. But this is a wonderfully cheerful symphony, but it's also incredibly sarcastic. Shostakovich and Stalin didn't get along very well. And so, in particular, I want to point out the wonderful trombone solo that Grant Carson is going to do for us, because it's two notes. Bum bum. Because apparently Shostakovich felt that Stalin could only figure that much out. So you'll hear at one point where the trombonist frantically keeps going bum bum, bum bum, bum bum. Like, no, it's this key, it's this key, it's this key. Anyway, it's a marvelous, marvelous, marvelous symphony. Has a lot of great. Great solos that will feature many of our fine instrumentalists here, and it's been a great pleasure to be able to come back and have an orchestra after our hiatus due to COVID. So I want to thank the orchestra for all of their hard work, and as I promised, I'm going to stop talking. Thank you.
Thank you.